Welcome to iCare Central. This video is on Schirmer's test. Schirmer's test was devised by a German ophthalmologist, Dr. Otto Schirmer, in the year 1903. It is done for the evaluation of suspected cases of dry eye disease. It measures specifically the deficiency of the aqueous layer of the tear film. We know that the tear film has three layers: the lipid layer, the aqueous layer, and the innermost mucin layer. Schirmer's test is abnormal in diseases that affect the middle layer or the aqueous layer of the tear film. Let's do a little revision of the physiology of tear secretion and tear drainage before proceeding further. Tears are produced by the main as well as the accessory lacrimal glands. These tears are secreted into the supralateral fornix of the conjunctiva and they spread over the ocular surface. Tears are drained by the lacrimal drainage system. The drainage starts at the lacrimal puncta. Then the tears travel to the lacrimal canaliculi, then to the lacrimal sac, and finally, via the nasolacrimal duct, the tears are drained into the inferior meatus of the nose. The tears produced by the lacrimal glands are of three types: reflex tears, basal tears, and psychogenic or emotional tears. Reflex tears are produced by the lacrimal glands in response to any irritation of the ocular surface. The purpose of reflex tearing is to wash out the cause of ocular irritation. Basal tears are tears that are produced by the lacrimal glands to keep the surface of the eye moist. So they are the basic functional tears that are produced to keep the ocular surface healthy and smooth. The main lacrimal gland is responsible for reflex tearing, while the accessory lacrimal glands produce basal tears. Schirmer's test measures the secretory capacity of the lacrimal glands. It is important to understand that Schirmer's test measures how much tear is secreted by the glands and not how much tear fluid they produced, because sometimes the tear production may be normal, but the tears don't get secreted if the ducts are blocked or stenosed. Since it represents the secretory function of the lacrimal glands, that is why it specifically measures the aqueous layer of the tear film. Schirmer's test is done using commercially available Schirmer's strip, or it can be done using Wattman filter paper number 41. The size of the strip is 5 mm by 35 mm. Schirmer 1. In Schirmer 1, the Schirmer strip is folded at the end and placed in the inferior fornix. This filter paper acts as an irritant on the eye and activates the lacrimation reflex pathway. When lacrimation reflex pathway is activated, afferent signals are carried via the trigeminal nerve to the superior salivatory nucleus in the brain stem. The efferent signal is carried via the parasympathetic secretomotor fibers to innervate the lacrimal gland, and tears are produced. If you wish to understand this reflex more in detail, I have a separate video on this topic. I'll post a link to that video in the description box below. So how do you perform Schirmer 1? First of all, you wash your hands. Don't put any eye drop, either an anesthetic or any antibiotic, before Schirmer 1 because that may give false results. Take out two strips from the pack and label them R for right eye and L for left eye. Explain the procedure to the patient. Tell them that the procedure may be a little uncomfortable, but it will not be painful. Fold a strip 5 mm from its margin and keep it in the fornix at the junction of the lateral 1/3 and the medial 2/3 of the lower lid. Make sure that the strip does not touch the cornea. Ask the patient to gently close his eyes. The eyes must not be squeezed. After 5 minutes, remove the strips and record the reading. Normal reading is more than 15 mm of wetting of the strip after 5 minutes. Mild dry eye is 10 to 14 mm of wetting. Moderate dry eye is 6 to 9 mm, while less than 5 mm is indicative of severe aqueous deficiency. It is also important to note that in almost 1/3 of elderly patients, the lacrimal gland function decreases as part of the aging process. Therefore, in them, readings of more than 10 mm are considered normal. Schirmer 1 measures basal as well as reflex tear secretion. Schirmer 2. In Schirmer 2, first anesthetic eye drop is instilled into the eye and then Schirmer strip is placed. Anesthetic eye drop inhibits reflex tearing, and thus Schirmer 2 measures only basal tear secretion. Since accessory lacrimal glands are responsible for basal tearing, Schirmer 2 represents the secretory function of only the accessory lacrimal glands and not that of the main lacrimal gland. Schirmer 2 is better tolerated by some patients because a rough paper can be quite irritating. The drawback is that the application of anesthetic eye drop may affect the results of the various staining tests done for diagnostic evaluation of dry eye disease that are usually performed after Schirmer's test. Also, it is quite difficult to isolate true basal secretion because sometimes the anesthesia may be incomplete or psychogenic factors may contribute to tear production as well. Schirmer 3. In Schirmer 3, the nasal mucosa is stimulated with the help of a cotton bud at the level of the middle meatus, and the amount of wetting of the Schirmer strip placed in the lower fornix is measured. Neither the nasal mucosa nor the ocular surface is anesthetized prior to stimulation. The principle behind this test is that the afferent fibers from the ocular surface as well as those from the nasal mucosa both are carried by the same nerve, that is the trigeminal nerve, and these signals converge in the superior salivatory nucleus of the brainstem and they activate it. We learned previously that efferent secretomotor fibers from the superior salivatory nucleus innervate the lacrimal glands. Thus, this activation of superior salivatory nucleus via the stimulation of nasal mucosa induces reflex tearing from the lacrimal gland. Schirmer 3 measures the maximum secretory capacity of the lacrimal glands, which means the maximum amount of tears that the lacrimal glands are capable of producing. Schirmer 3 test is done in those patients who get borderline low scores on Schirmer 1. By borderline score, we mean 10 mm of wetting of Schirmer strip. If a patient gets a borderline low score on Schirmer 1, the nasal mucosa is stimulated to induce more reflex tearing. And if there is no increase in the wetting of Schirmer strip, or maybe just a little increase of less than 1 mm after nasal stimulation, it is indicative of Sjögren's disease because Sjögren's disease destroys the structure of the lacrimal gland and reflex tears cannot be produced. One more thing that is important to know is the variation in the nomenclature of these tests. Some texts divide Schirmer 1 into 1A and 1B, that is Schirmer done without anesthesia and Schirmer done with anesthesia, while Schirmer 2 is the version done with nasal stimulation. So that is all for this video. Please like and share it with your friends and colleagues if you found it useful. Please subscribe to my channel to support free education. Thank you very much.